Down here, I have two incredible mid-range devices from Samsung and Poco. Firstly, I have the Samsung Galaxy A52 5G and also the Xiaomi Poco X3 Pro. So today, we'll be comparing the differences, the similarities, and which one should you buy at the given price point. First, let's talk about the price. I'll be giving out the base prices because those are the models that I got. So the Poco X3 Pro, it costs about $300 US dollars. And the Samsung Galaxy A52 5G costs about $450. Both have 128 gigs of base storage. The Poco is about 2/3 the price. So if you're getting the Poco, you're saving $150. There is a reason why the Galaxy A52 5G costs higher than the Poco. For example, the A52 5G feels premium, although not on a similar scale to the Galaxy Note 20 Ultra I've been using, but it still feels quite premium for a mid-range device. On the other hand, the Poco feels cheaper. Materials not only feel not as sturdy, but the glossy plastic also make it look a bit worse, and it just have all in all a kind of mid-range look. Having a mid-range look is not a bad thing. In fact, sometimes I prefer it because it often looks more distinctive compared to flagship. The Poco X3 Pro feels way heavier than the Galaxy A52 5G. And the weight difference is not that much. It is 215 grams versus 192 on the Galaxy. But what's really make it different is that Samsung tried to lay it out better and it's more balanced. Like the Galaxy A52 5G is a more balanced phone, so you won't feel the weight as much as the Poco X3 Pro, which is not so balanced. For the display, both are 1080p, both are 120Hz, but Samsung wins by having deeper contrast levels with its AMOLED panel. The display on the Galaxy is also way brighter by quite a huge margin. Samsung makes the world's best displays, and many times their mid-range displays can even beat a flagship. So Samsung wants in the displays. How about the cameras? So both cameras are pretty capable for the price point of each. Both feature quad camera setups, with the Samsung getting a 64MP main camera opposed to the 48MP main camera on the Poco X3 Pro. So the Samsung has 12MP of ultra-wide camera, 8MP for the Poco, and both features a macro as well as a depth sensor, but they are kinda useless. At normal lighting, the main camera on the Poco is good. It is sharp, it is clear, it is all you will need for a good photo. But for the ultra wide, it's a bit less reliable. As you can see here, it is a bit losing a bit of detail, and the quality of the sensor is just not so good, so it cannot process it too well. At daytime, you can't really distinguish the shots between the Xiaomi Poco X3 Pro as well as the Galaxy A52. Both are pretty comparable, but the Galaxy wins in the ultra wide camera, having more megapixels as well as better image processing and higher dynamic range. So this ultra-wide camera is actually quite impressive for the price. Okay, next is the selfie camera, and they're both, they're okay. Nothing too surprising, but also expected. Both devices has night mode, so I decided to try them out. And late at night, I just went out my door and found a pretty good spot. So first off, I started off with the Poco X3 Pro. In night mode, it's quite good. I mean, have a look at the end result. For a $300 phone, this is the quality I expect. At mediocre lighting, it is bright enough to show the subject clearly, and also not too much noise. The ultra wide, on the other hand, didn't do so well. It is still alright, I guess. The Galaxy, on the other hand, the moment I turn out the viewfinder, I realized that the image from the viewfinder is way better than I seen on the Poco X3 Pro. The Galaxy has a better chance of taking a good shot thanks to its optical image stabilization. But honestly, I wasn't expecting by how shocked I am by a mid-range device having such a capable camera even at nighttime. I mean, just look at this shot. Everything is pretty clear. You can see the shadows clearly. It has good detail and very little noise. I can't even see it. And the ultra-wide camera, although it's a bit worse, it is not too bad. I would still make it passable, which is very good for a mid-range device like this. Just for comparison, I put out a flagship. I was thinking whether I should bring my iPhone or my Galaxy, but I decided to bring my Galaxy Note 20 Ultra, as it has way better nighttime photos thanks to its big sensor. And the results are even better than the A52 5G, which is of course expected. But just put the A52 photo beside, you can see that while the A52 5G is 1/3 the price of the Note 20 Ultra, it delivers about 2/3 the performance in nighttime shots and overall photography. Back to the Poco X3 Pro, I decided to give it a more challenging shot where the lighting is almost zero. So this is the shot on the main camera, I can see it's really grainy already. And the ultra wide, it's a hell of a lot worse, but I I'm not really surprised by it because this is really terrible lighting. There's almost no light and it was really dark, I almost can't see it. But again, the A52 5G is there to impress me again with another great shot, even when the lighting is almost non-existent. The A52 5G also suffered a lot with the ultra-wide shot, but it's still quite clear compared to the Poco X3 Pro. Just for fun, I pulled up my Galaxy Note 20 Ultra again and took an ultra-wide nighttime shot. And again, it also impressed me, but I'm not too surprised by paying almost $1,200 for it. The Galaxy also win in video performance. Look at the Xiaomi shot, it is quite shaky, but if you do the same thing with the Samsung, it is way more stable thanks to optical image stabilization. While the Galaxy have a way better camera than the Poco X3 Pro, the Poco X3 Pro is also still not bad. And while the Poco X3 Pro is cheaper, it has better performance than the Galaxy A52 5G. Firstly, the Galaxy runs One UI 3 on top of Android 11, and the Poco X3 Pro runs MIUI 12 on top of Android 11 as well. I also expect the Poco to get updates to Android 13, while the Galaxy should get to Android 14, but the Galaxy is more expensive, so that's reasonable. Okay, now the Poco X3 Pro wins in performing power. You see, the Poco X3 Pro has a Qualcomm Snapdragon 860 chipset, which is more like a flagship chipset, paired with 6GB of RAM. The Galaxy A52 5G also have 6GB of RAM, but instead gets a Qualcomm Snapdragon 750G, which is about a quarter to a third less powerful than the Qualcomm Snapdragon 860 on the Poco. So, most games should run very well. They are both still very powerful chipsets. For example, Brawl Stars both run very smoothly like butter. I'm also playing these games at its max volume, so this is a good chance to test out the speaker, which I find both to be about the same quality, both feature dual speakers. Now I'm gonna play COD Mobile, Call of Duty Mobile, at its highest settings on both devices. And for the Poco X3 Pro, I felt no lag at all, it's buttery smooth. Surprisingly, the Galaxy A52 5G also performed really well. I played at its higher settings and I do occasionally experience a frame rate drop, but other than that, it's still really smooth, and for day-to-day use, both devices will fly by. Speaking of day-to-day, both devices have probably one of the best battery lives I've ever experienced. On both devices, I often found myself ending off days with about 40 to 50% of battery life, which is incredible. The A52 5G has 25 watts of fast charging, while the Poco X3 Pro has 33 watts of fast charging, and both include the charger in the box. Now, let's talk about all the other similarities and differences between the two devices. So firstly, the Poco has a side-mounted fingerprint sensor, while the Galaxy has an optical in-display fingerprint sensor. And the Poco unlocks faster than the Galaxy. The Poco has IP53 splash resistance, while on the other hand, the Galaxy A52 5G has IP67 water resistance, which means I can just dunk it in a pool up to 1 meter for half an hour and it will still be fine. Okay, both have a headphone jack, both have dual speakers, and both use the port's USB Type-C. Both also have a similar display, being a hole punch design, and all in all, both are great devices. Depending on the budget you're looking at, the Poco X3 Pro is a great phone for $300. The Galaxy A52 5G is a brilliant phone for $450. The main thing separating these two devices is the price, but if you take that aside, the Galaxy A52 5G performed more superior compared to the Poco in most aspects. That being said, thanks for watching, I'll catch you guys in the next one.